The last speaker of this session is Pierre Mertens from Antwerp and our president of IF, the International Federation, well known to us all. And when Pierre has finished, we have a panel here, if we have time for one or two questions maybe before lunch. Welcome.
Thank you very much. Well, I would start with a question. Why should we prevent who we love? If its members, like RBU, are striving for the right of a decent life of all people with spina bifida to improve their lives, and we believe in their lives, and it's exactly this network, you all from all these different countries, this network of people with a condition who took the lead already many years ago in primary prevention. Because it is extremely good news that spina bifida can be prevented, and just by a simple vitamin. This is the network. If the IF network has primary prevention also in its mission statement, and we are advocating for the higher folic levels in the blood of all future mothers. IF promotes the intake of folic acid and advocates for fortification of stable food, as Carola said, with folic acid, and especially in the countries where there's high incidence of spina bifida. As partners of the flour fortification initiative, IF has also a program in training millers and also governments all over the world to fortify food with folic acid. But again, why should we prevent who we love? It's a discussion I often had with my wife, Mo. If folic acid could have prevented the neural tube of my daughter, Lisha, she would probably still be here. Today, she could have been 34 years old lady, married, having children, giving grandchildren to me. And she would not have had all these hospitalizations, not her incontinence, and also not the mobility problems. But my wife, Mo, always responded to it, but Lise was Lise, also because of her disabilities. It's the way she was, it's the way we loved her. And she would not have been the same and have the same spirit if she would have been born without a disability. With timely intervention and improved coordinated care like we are developing it everywhere, and with new surgical techniques like ETV, also today, Lise, having spina bifida, could still have been alive, being married and having children. But why should we prevent who we love? IF believes in the value, of course, of children with spina bifida, and therefore IF fights for the right to life and to all available treatment for the kid all over the world. That's why IF reacted strongly against the Groningen Protocol, where the lives of 22 children with spina bifida were actively terminated, advocating for euthanasia in newborns with severe disabilities. IF also advocates, and this is a drawing of a prenatal screening of a chicken. We saw the mice already, so why not the chickens? So we advocate for balanced and full information on the problems, but also on the treatment possibilities, on the abilities and the disabilities of children with spina bifida in the prenatal counseling. And of course, if you have a counselor like Margot, you can be sure that this counseling will be balanced. If questioned, the one-sided negative information given on spina bifida, which is resulting in this high figure of termination of pregnancies. And we think this is very sad. Due to the new coordinated care and the new surgical techniques, the expected quality of life has never been so good. The prognosis for spina bifida has never been so good as now. The adults who are sitting here, and that Sven said this morning, they went through a whole process of avant-garde, where doctors were looking for the right treatment and did also a lot of trials with falling and upstand and standing up. So if you are expecting a child now, the prognosis is much better than 30 years ago. Primary prevention and certainly prenatal diagnosis has to be combined with the availability of care. Parents will not have a choice if there is no treatment for this child when it is born. Then the choice is determined by society not welcoming our children. And also, prevention measures for the next generation should never have a judgment about the values of our lives, of the lives of persons with spina bifida. Because in my opinion, they play such an important role in the contemporary society where everybody is competing to have the right weight, the right color, and the right career. The good news for folic acid for me is that the same child is born without a disability. The same child is born without a disability. And the right to live is for me still the most fundamental human right. And that's the conference Carola already spoke about. We have to learn future mothers to go to the doctor before pregnancy, not when they are pregnancy. So if we invested a lot in the promotion of preconception care, where women can learn not to drink alcohol, not to smoke, not to take drugs, and to take folic acid daily when they want to become pregnant. Our campaign in Australia some years ago worded it as followed. If you stop the contraceptive pill, you have to take another pill, a pill called folic acid. But informing, and Carola said it already, it's very difficult to let a woman do what you want. So informing the general population is very difficult. And therefore, IF is still advocating for mandatory fortification of stable food with folic acid. And for Europe, this is flour. It is not an or story, it is an and story. We have to combine flour fortification, but even with flour fortification, women are advised to take supplements, as said before by my colleagues. Europe should take responsibility towards his citizens and really make sure that every woman has the right information at the right time. And our report was presented in a hearing in the European Parliament last year, and it gives you an insight, and we have some copies with us about the situation in Europe. Coming back to my question, why should we prevent who we love? No, we have to take care of who we love. We have to take care, but by taking care, we see their valuable lives, we see also their problems. And if we can prevent these problems for the next generation, for newborns, of course, we should do it. When my daughter Lisha died, I did not miss her wheelchair. I missed Lisha. Her smile, her heart, her love, and it's because we love that we prevent. Thank you.